pop.
You gotta make it distinctive. That single string gotta stand out by itself. Da dee. You gotta hesitate. Da dee. Da dee, hold that dee. Da da da.
Oh. She gonna say it's tight as a button.
Would you make the chord? Make the chord. Yeah, hit the chord, and then you can Roddy.
Okay. Oh.
Hey.
Oh. Okay.
All six strings. Body, then get all six. We got five. Get the bass string. Church song you know how to play. They play when you go to church, you know.
Mm-hmm. I got a song called Lord You Are Awesome.
Uh-huh.
It's called Lord You Are Awesome. But like, another song that I know, I Surrender All. Yeah, I play with the church. See, I don't really do too much singing. You know, I just play, and sometimes if I don't know the exact chords, I'll just fiddle around. You know, I'll fiddle around, I'll put like little embellishments and with the song, because the songs that they play, it really is a guitar player in them songs. So I gotta kinda find my way. And being as though the keyboard player is already playing all the chords, you know, me and him playing the chords together, it'll just be clashing, you know? So most of the time, I just like, you know, say they playing, say the keyboard playing something like. I'll be doing something like this. I'll make little embellishments, unless it's a song that we rehearse where I got a major part. But you know, other than that, I just put little embellishments. The keyboard player, he's doing everything already. The bass player, you know.
That's what I was trying to get around to finding out what you were doing. Mm-hmm. See, because talking is one thing, but doing is something else. And piano and guitar. Yeah, just about on the same.
Yeah.
Be on the same level there.
Yeah.
And unless you know how to cut, play a lot of stop. I play a lot of stop chords. And when piano doing this thing, you plunk chords.
Yeah. I know what you mean.
Chop chords. With a piano, when the piano is going, you chop.
Mm-hmm. Or play in the higher register.
Yeah. Or fumble around from the bottom to top.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That gives it a mellow flavor. Mm-hmm. Gives it a flavor that, you know, it's different.
Mm-hmm.
They better even come to church and people start singing a song.
I gotta play along. I can follow somebody. I can follow somebody on the
chart. I'm gonna follow somebody to see if ain't nobody they're singing. Ain't no musician at the church.
Yeah. He told me, I asked him what the music, he said it wasn't none.
Yeah.
But if somebody was to start singing, I'll listen to what key. I'll listen to him go around one time so I can, then I'll know what chords to hit. You know, because most of the time when gospel singers singing, they sing. They always go from that tonic to that third.
But now you got the wrong idea now. I understand what you're saying. Mm-hmm. But you want them to gospel singer standpoint. Mm-hmm. But when you're in a church like this, they the old time singers. They sing them old time songs. Therefore, you got to play old timey so they'll know where you at.
Right.
You can't get fancy with them.
Mm-hmm. Just keep it straight.
Yeah.
Keep it straight.
So they'll know when to come in. They already off time anyway. Brian has to keep on time. Thank you.
I'll definitely be looking up on my church, old church songs. You know, I got a hymn book. You know, by the time I get ready to come to the church, I already had a feel of that old time. Well, I already do because they sing old church hymns at my but they only sing like one or two old church songs. Other than that, it's all like modern day gospel music.
You got to get that one. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Not that one.
You not talking about that one?
No, it's a new one. God has spoken.
Oh, you talking about that? So let the church say amen.
You got to get in order to get with it.